time for another Craftea Chat. So Craftea Chat Podcast episode 2. Welcome. If it's your first time viewing this podcast, I hope that you enjoy it enough to hit subscribe. This Craftea Chat Podcast is a fortnightly podcast, so you get it every other Thursday. My name is Hannah. I am British, as you can hear, but I am currently living in Frankfurt in Germany, and it's quite chilly. It is the 24th of November today, so happy Thanksgiving to those of you in the US or from the US, or those of you who celebrate Thanksgiving today. Happy Thanksgiving to you all. I had my first Thanksgiving experience on Saturday. I will discuss more about that later on. But yes, it's a nice sunny day here in Frankfurt today, and the Christmas market started yesterday, so it's a lot of fun. I'm the corner of craft on most social media. I'm the corner of craft on Ravelry and on Instagram and all of that fun stuff. Links to all of my social media can be found in the description box of the video, as well as other links that I think are relevant. Also, the Craftea Chat Podcast does have a Ravelry group, so you can join in the chat there, because the purpose of a Craftea Chat is to drink tea, craft, and chat, because that is what a Craftea Chat is. I'm enjoying some Indusha chai tea today. My cup is wet. How annoying. But yes, it's like a vanilla chai. It's very tasty. It's by Westcliff. So, yeah. So let's get on into it, because I'm sure that's why a lot of you are watching. This is, I haven't even said what kind of podcast this is. This is a knitting and crochet podcast. At the moment I am making Christmas presents, so it's a predominantly sock knitting podcast right now, but I am going to branch out once I've got all of these socks finished. I just don't want to start something else and get distracted and into that. But once again, more on what I would like to knit is coming later on. And this jumper is far too baggy on me now. How sad. It's a Kath Kidston one. And it's real nice because it's got cute little red squirrels on the pocket. And I got it last Christmas. But I'm 2 stone, 28 pounds lighter than I was last Christmas. As in, 2 stone is 28 pounds. Just a bit of conversion. Around 15 kilos, I think. Yeah, so it's just big on me now. But yes. The things we have to do. Okay, so whips and hose. I don't actually have any half objects this week. When I say this week, I mean this fortnight. But yeah. One of my works in progress is actually kind of, they look finished, but they're not. So I made these on in Sunday's tutorial. I was actually inspired by the Yarngasm Ornament Along 2016. And Jodie from the Grocery Girls has also been making crochet snowflakes. So I made some crochet snowflakes. But it's a work in progress because I need to make more of them and then string them together because I want to make a little snowflake garland, because I have a granny heart garland going along down under there. But I want to replace it with snowflakes for Christmas, or have it in the window, or have it behind here, have it somewhere. But I've only got 2 right now. But if you want to make these yourself, I actually do have a tutorial for it. I posted it on Sunday. It's not my own original pattern. I won't take credit for that. But I also show you how to block acrylic, because this is just cheap acrylic yarn that I bought for a project I needed. Just super cheap acrylic yarn. I got it in the UK. New fashion, double knitting by Woolcraft. But it does the job. I have nothing against acrylic yarn, as you will see. So my next work in progress, I got my little cat notebook with all my little notes in it. I'm so organized and so professional, but I also haven't put anything in an order, so. So these socks are for one of my in-laws. Luckily everyone I'm knitting socks for has the same size feet as me, so it's very convenient. But this is in the main body of it, is this yarn here. It's a nice bit of regia. Regia Monaco colour, well, colour, sorry. But Regia Monaco colour, the colour is 01839, and apparently it's called Lavato Ringlet. I don't know. In Germany, they don't seem to print the colour on the label, so I've had to do a bit of Googling. And then I'm using a contrasting heel cuffs and toes, which is just like a little skein. Which is Regia Baby Smiles and the colour for that is 01036, and that is in the colour pink. And I'm just doing a basic vanilla sock. It's basically Villainvine's favourite sock pattern, but I've learnt a new heel, which is quite exciting, and I will talk about that when I get to finished things. I'm using 2.5mm needles, 64 stitches, and these are just really cheap DPNs because I need some new DPNs because I feel like cheap needles bend quite a lot, and these needles are bending, but they're doing the job for now, and that suits me fine. But I will probably pick that up when I start chatting about other things that I don't have to demonstrate. Quick tea break. Although I have only just made them, so it's probably too hot. Okay, so now we're on to finished things. I have been a bit of a sock machine this week. So you saw this was a half object last time I saw you. Now I have two of them. These socks are for my boyfriend for Christmas. He has big feet, so he needs big socks, because you know what they say, if you've got big feet, you need big socks. So this is Vendita yarn, which I just got cheap from Aldi. Number 8 for the body of it, and then number 01 for heel, toes and cuffs. And he tries them on. He's tried them on because I needed to know foot sizing and stuff such. So he knows he's getting them, but I've hidden them away, so hopefully he'll forget what they look like, because I know him, you know? I know what he's like. He tends to forget things. And this next finished object, Julia, if you're watching, please skip ahead to the time frame on the screen, or timestamp on the screen, because I don't want you to see these. But it is, have you skipped? I hope she skipped. These socks actually took me 4 days to make, which I'm very proud about. And coincidentally, they match my, almost, not quite, they almost match my crochet hook case. Which, they almost match that, which I'm quite impressed with. This yarn is, I didn't look it up beforehand because I'm very disorganized, 03726. It's Regia once again. It's just a 4-ply colour. And it's just lots of different colours. And I bought a big ball because I'm going to get 2 pairs of socks out of this. And because I was going to get 2 pairs of socks out of it, I made them short socks because I wanted to be sure that I'd get 2 pairs of socks out of it. Because I know I can if I don't make them match. But yeah, it's really easy making matching socks because you knit down to the same part of the stripe. And yeah, much easier. I potentially made these a little too short. I mean, they fit my feet, so hopefully they'll fit her feet too. Once again, 2.5 needles, 64 stitches. I forgot to say for Mario socks, I used 72 stitches and they seem to fit quite well. And then for the heels, toes and cuffs, this is once again one of the regia small balls of yarn, and that is 01053, and that colour is apparently sky blue, but I haven't ever seen a sky this colour, so, but it matched really well. So I ran with it. But I will be having another pair of these knitting up soon after I've finished the Levato ringlet. And then the final pair of socks that I have this week. Atkinson, if you are watching, skip ahead to the timestamp. Although now you already know you're getting socks because I wasn't organized enough. But skip ahead. I saw this yarn and thought of my best friend from home, so. And you'll notice I have a different heel. Ooh. So I actually attempted the Fish Lips Kiss heel for the first time. But anyway, I will talk about that in a second. This is Regia Design Line Kappa Facet 02904 in the Delphinium colorway. But on my project page, I called them my Aurora Borealis socks because they remind me of the Northern Lights. Because, yeah. But I need to knit myself a pair using this yarn and the ace. So once again, I made the cuffs short because I'm knitting presents, I need to get them out. So I've got short little length, and then my first Fish Lips Kiss heel, which fits me quite well. I am using sock knitting for presents as a little experiment to see what my perfect sock is. And the Fish Lips Kiss heel is really easy to do. I'm not gonna lie, first time I did it, I was a little bit stressed and a little bit like, oh my God, I can't believe I have to do this. It's not that bad. It's a super cheap pattern. If you haven't heard many other knitting podcasters talk about it, it costs £1, or $1.20. I think it's a dollar if you're in the US, but $1.20 if you're in the EU, because we've got different download VAT laws. But yeah, and it's just an alternative heel. You don't have to knit. You don't have to knit a heel flap like I have with these. So yeah, it's just a bit easier because then you don't have to count and decrease here. You can just get knitting again, which is much easier because I like knitting in social situations. So on a Sunday, we go and watch American football in a sports bar and I'm sat knitting then. And then when I'm playing Dungeons and Dragons, I sit and knit then. It just makes knitting go a bit quicker. And I'm not saying that I don't enjoy knitting, because I clearly do, because I've kind of got a bit addicted to it. And it's like a super soft yarn. It's not like the softest yarn I've ever felt. Like, Regia isn't the softest of yarns, but it's nice to work with and it's durable. And it's 75% wool, 25% polyamide, and that's what all of the yarns that I've been using are. Anyway, on to the last finished objects. Like I said, been a little bit of a machine this past fortnight. I was commissioned to make 8 dice bags by someone that I played Dungeons and Dragons with. If you're not sure what a dice bag is, it's a bag that holds your dice, which sounds really stupid and like I'm trying to belittle you to explain it. But in Dungeons and Dragons, you use around 6 or 7 dice. And it's nice to keep them all together, and so I was given a list of colours and charms, and I made some dice bags. So this first dice bag, so like I said, this is just, I mentioned this in my last podcast, this is my own pattern, it's my own design. The colours aren't colours that I have chosen. I was given a list of a primary and a secondary colour. So this one was red and green, and I didn't want to make it look Christmassy. So I went with a slightly darker red, and I went with a not Christmas green. And it's got a little axe charm on the side. And all of the yarns that I used are just acrylic style craft yarns. The bead is just a plastic bead that I've had since childhood. And the charms I found on Etsy, and it was a UK seller. And I think I've got it somewhere here. Nicole de Bruin. NicoleDeBruin. And she's on Etsy, and she's got her own website and whatnot. And she sent a cute little, I don't want to give you the 25% discount code because I want to use it. She sent a cute little reindeer charm with it because I bought quite a few for this project. But yeah, and now you've seen the, discount code, but whatever, whatever. I'm sure it's not one for one. I'm sure anyone can use it, but yes. That's the first one. Second one, the colours were turquoise, gold, and a unicorn charm. So I used a gold bead because I don't have any gold yarn. Gold bead, black string, and then this really cute unicorn charm. And I've got a few of them, so I think I might make some into stitch markers for me. Super cute. Then we've got blue, red, and a shield. So that's what we've gone with. Blue, red, and a shield. Once again, these are all Stylecraft yarns. And so then we got blue, black, and a hammer, which is super cute. And the blue kind of matches my nails, because I didn't want to go for like a normal blue, I wanted to go for like a teal, because that's just what I am. This one is black, red, and a dagger. I think it's for a rogue, if it focuses. Come on, there we go. Sorry for all the autofocus noise, I know it's happening. I can't hear it myself, but the little dagger charm's pretty cute. As cute as a dagger charm can be. And then we've got black, green, and a spell book, which is quite cool. Just a little spell book there. And they got two more, and these are both black with a dragon, but one has red, and we wanted different dragons for them. So they went matchy-matchy. So this is black, red with a dragon, And then this one is black and blue with a dragon. And I really like this little dragon. And once again, I have quite a few of these. So I think I will be making them into stitch markers. Because why not? But yes, it's been socks galore and dice bags galore in the corner of craft this week. It's a bit crazy. But that is all my works in progress and all of my finished objects for this past fortnight. I'm quite impressed, I'm not gonna lie. When I first thought about knitting socks for people for Christmas, I thought it was going to take eons to knit them all, but actually, this pair took longer to knit, but this pair took 4 days to knit, which I think is incredible. I finished this pair yesterday and I think I cast them on. I can't remember when I cast them on. I cast them on as soon as I finished these, so maybe these took a week to knit. And it's only because I've been playing The Sims a bit more. So in my last podcast, I asked you what I should make with the gorgeous yarns that I bought. And I wasn't sure. And I have decided, so this is in future knits. So these are things that I'd like to knit and I'm planning to knit and not just things that I dream of. But I've decided I'm going to go for the All About That Brioche shawl. Because you know I'm all about that brioche in shawl form. But yeah, I've never done brioche before and it looks fun and snuggly and squishy and I feel like this shawl will be quite a good introduction. I'll stick a picture of it in so you know what it looks like. But it's got like garter stitch and then it's got a brioche panel and then more garter stitch in the other colour. And I just think that would be really cool. That's by Lisa Hans or Lisa Hannes. I'm not quite sure where she is from. But this yarn is from Das Monschaf. This is in Vollmondnacht and this is in Hokkaido. And my friend corrected me last week because Hokkaido is a type of pumpkin. Of course it's a type of pumpkin. I knew it was a type of pumpkin. My brain just didn't put the two and two together. Vollmondnacht means like night of the full moon. And it's just this real nice teal color. And this real nice, well, now I'm going to say pumpkin colour. And this is what I'm going to knit as soon as I've finished these socks. I've got the rest of these pink socks to knit. And then I've got another pair of the this socks to knit. And then I'm done. And then I can cast this on. Also, I think I might ask, my boyfriend asked me what I wanted for Christmas. I think I might be cheeky and ask for a set of higher, higher, sharp interchangeables. Because I feel like I'd use them lots. But anyway, enough about that. I'll pop that back in my stash bag. You know your stash is small when you can carry it in a carrier bag. It's not my fault. Also, I really want to make one of these granny stripe blankets. Because I mean, I've got my Cozy Memories blanket, which is very small, and I think I may have added one square since I last spoke to you. This is just in the yarn that Mary's sock is out of. And the problem with using, for example, I used one ball of yarn to make these two socks. I don't have much left over to add a square. It makes me feel a bit sad. But anyway, I have my Cozy Memories blanket, and that's all well and good. But I have an excess of acrylic yarn from when I was, and still am, into making amigurumi, which is... this is an amigurumi. It's just like a little crocheted stuffy, little stuffed animal. And yeah, so I have a lot of scraps there and I was thinking I could make a granny stripe out of all of those DK scraps. Because I've seen a lot of people make granny stripe blankets and now I feel sad that I started one of these. I mean, it's not very big, so I could start again with the granny stripe, but I also quite like this. I'm torn. This is the problem with watching too many podcasts. I want to knit all of the things. Also in future knits, my friend and neighbor Soprano Knits, aka Becky, aka host of the Stringing It Together podcast, has released a new pattern into the wild. She released it yesterday, last night. It's the Beckline pattern, which is like a small brook or like a small stream, German word. So that's the Beckline by Becky Sorensen, and she's actually got a 20% off code through the weekend, so you get 20% off your pattern with the code THANKFUL, because it's Thanksgiving. But yeah, I really want to knit this Beckline shawl because it looks really nice, so I'm hoping that she has a Beckline knit along So I have an excuse to buy yarn and participate. Because it's a really nice shawl. Like, I haven't properly... I have looked at all of the photos, but I haven't studied what techniques and stitches are in it. So I'm not 100% sure if I'd be able to do it. But I know Becky, so if worse comes to worse, she can help me out. I intend on asking her to help me out with brioche as well at some point, but I think that's going to be something I'm going to knit over Christmas. Take it on the plane with me, knit it over Christmas. It'll be good fun. Oh, my phone just buzzed, so I don't know where it is. But yes, that is in future knits, along with all of the other things that I mentioned last week, like the exploration station. Oh, that's still a dream. Still where I want to do that. But the problem, it's just like, and the excuse me shawl, that's also by Stephen West. That's the brioche shawl that I was talking about last week that I said that Becky had knitted and that I was in love with. I did a bit of a stalk of her Ravelry project pages and found it out, and yeah, it's a stunning, stunning scarf slash shawl, and I really want to make it, but I don't currently have the funds to spend on beautiful yarn, which... If I'm going to spend that long making something, I want to use something that's high quality, you know? So going around YouTube at the moment is... No, going around Instagram at the moment is a little hashtag, which is get your yarn wishes granted. And I really like the idea of this. So there's a picture that I... and you... In the description of the picture, you say what your yarn wish is. It can be either a pattern, it can be needles, it can be minis, it can be a particular type of yarn, and you say, this is my yarn wish. And then you go on the hashtag and you search all of the other ones and you grant somebody else's wish. And then when you've granted someone else's wish, you can post another wish. And I think it's a really good idea. I bought a pattern for someone the other day, which made me feel quite good about myself. And I've got some people sending me some mini skeins, so my blanket will be able to grow because it's looking very sorry for itself right now. So I'm excited for that. But it's a really nice thing to get involved with. The knitting community is such a wonderful place. Everyone is very loving and caring, and why aren't I knitting? That is a thing I should be doing. It's a crafty chat. I always knit when I'm not showing things. But it's a really nice thing to get involved with. And I don't know. I just think if you've got something lingering in your stash that you aren't going to use, you may as well gift it to someone who desperately wants it, you know? There's lots of people who want to try out like various yarn companies and such, so get involved and your yarn wish may be granted too, which is fun. So now we're going to talk about a few podcaster recommendations, and once again I'm only going to do three because I watch a lot of podcasts, and so I'm just going to do a few. So the first one is the Pin Feathers and Pearls podcast, which is hosted by Candice with her little feathery co-host Yoshi, which is a little green bird that she has. I don't know what kind of bird it is because I'm not a birdie expert, but he's super cute. But yes, Pin Feathers and Pearls podcast. And she actually has a knit along going at the minute, which is the Socks in Space Cow, which is where you use yarn that is either inspired by space or named after something like a fandom, like, you know, Star Trek, Star Wars, or Doctor Who, obviously. Or you knit a pattern which is inspired by. So I have found the Impossible Girl socks, which I am trying to just find the perfect yarn for, but all the yarn that I can seem to find that's here, I think is too busy. I mean, I might be wrong, but I'll keep looking and see. I might just have to do a plain color if not, but that's a bit boring. I like a plain colour when it's tonal, but then that's not a plain colour. That's the problem with like factory stuff. Because it's got like a cabling down it, and I just think it's really nice. But yes, there's a Socks in Space knit along happening over there at the minute. And then there's Inside Number 23, which is hosted by Katie, who is British, and it's always nice to have somebody within Europe, watching someone within Europe podcasting, because as entertaining as all of these podcasters are from North America, unfortunately shipping from, well, Canada's not as bad, but shipping from the US in particular is disgustingly expensive. I really wanted to buy a skein of yarn and realized that if I wanted to buy the skein of yarn plus shipping, the shipping was the same price as the skein of yarn, so really frustrating. But hey, so it's nice to watch podcasters from either the UK or within Europe, because she buys some nice yarn that has slightly cheaper postage cost. And I understand why postage is as much as, well, I don't understand why, people charge as much as they do for postage, because obviously the cost of shipping something from the US must be extortionate, but it still makes me sad. But hey, that's what you get. And then the final podcast is that one I mentioned earlier, and it's the Grocery Girls podcast. And I've found these this past couple of weeks and have kind of just been a bit addicted to watching them, like watching back episodes. And that's when I know a podcast is good. If I just watch a podcast and then just watch them as they come out, then it's obviously not as good. Well, it's still good. It just hasn't grasped me in the same kind of way. But that is hosted by sisters Jodie and Tracy, and they are just hilarious. They're just really funny people who are a joy to watch, and they make really interesting things, and they bounce off each other really well. And yeah, they're just really entertaining. So links to all of those can be found in the description box, as well as in the Ravelry group, where I've posted the show notes. I hate calling them show notes, but I don't know what else to call them right now. And now we are going to move on to the Corner of Craft YouTube and what's been happening on there this past fortnight. And also words, come on Hannah, my life, just about my life. I can't believe I couldn't think of that. So if that doesn't interest you, I thank you very much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed the podcast. It's a bit shorter than some other people, but if you're sticking around, feel free and let's go. So the Corner of Craft YouTube this past fortnight, we've had 3 videos since I last saw you. We've had a zigzag friendship bracelet, because you guys seem to enjoy friendship bracelet tutorials. All the people that watch my video, like watch the tutorials and not just the podcast, seem to enjoy my friendship bracelet tutorials. So it's always a treat filming one of them, even if the editing is a massive pain sometimes and takes longer than making the bracelet itself, which is surprising considering a bracelet can be made up of hundreds of knots, which is weird. Also, side note, I worked out that in each of these there is over 500 stitches, over 570 stitches or something, which is ridiculous in a dice bag, and that's not including the string around. Baffling, but hopefully the kids will like them and appreciate them and not just lose them as soon as they receive them, because you know what some children can be like. So yeah, I had a nice zigzag friendship bracelet video, and then I also made a video of Christmas gift ideas for crafty people. So that video is for people like you, like me, who may be a little bit crafty, and if you have loved ones who don't know what to get you for Christmas. I feel like that sentence structure was wrong, but I don't know how else to say it. Then just send them this video and just like massively hint, or send them the video with a list of timestamps so they know what to have. In there is just like yarn, because you can never have too much yarn, sets of needles. My friend Anna suggested a thermos, one of those, you know, thermal mugs. Here's a thermal mug, right? That you have tea and coffee in and it keeps everything warm or everything cold. A thermos flask, if you will. That kind of thing. So it's got a range of price points. So if that's something you're interested in, feel free to check that out. And then finally, it's the crochet snowflakes that I showed earlier on. They're actually really easy to make, and I'm not gonna lie, they only take a quarter of an hour to make each, which means they are great to make, and you don't have to make them. I made mine out of acrylic double knit yarn, but you don't have to make them out of double knit. You can make them out of crochet cotton and use a smaller sized hook. That is perfectly acceptable, because that way you could dangle them off presents, and you'd have to string them together as a garland. You can just pop ribbon through them or something and hang them as little tree decorations, and I think that'll be really cute. And it would enter you into the ornament along, which is on the Yarngasm podcast group, and I think that's going on till December 15th, so I need to get on it, because yes. And this week we have another yarny video coming up, I think, if I'm going to film what I plan to film tomorrow. But yeah. So that's what's been going on in the Corner of Craft YouTube. If you're subscribed, then you would already know that. So feel free to hit subscribe if that is something that you are interested in doing. Also, if you don't want to hit subscribe, that's also perfectly acceptable, and I will still accept you as a viewer and friend. Such a nice tea. Okay, finally, I'm just gonna give you a little update on my life, and it's been all right this past fortnight. It's not been too bad. The Christmas markets are now here in Frankfurt, which is always a delight to walk around. I've had a bit of difficulty adjusting to weather, I think, or daylight savings, or I'm not sure. In our bedroom, we have a blind, which means that it is pitch. I can put the blind down and that bedroom will be pitch black, which is delightful. But also means in the morning when I wake up, I don't actually know what time it is. So I've actually had difficulty waking up before 10:30. To the point where at the moment it is 10 to 12, which means I should finish soon, because otherwise the bells are gonna go ballistic. But because I live near the dorm in Frankfurt, which is like the cathedral, but it's actually just a big church because it's not actually a cathedral. Very confusing, I don't really understand. But anyway, yeah, so I've had difficulty waking up and getting out of bed before, well, getting out of bed before midday, but waking up before 10:30. So today, I actually set my alarm for 8:30 and got up at 9:30, which is a small achievement. But yeah, I think the weather is affecting my brain a little bit. And my brain isn't enjoying it, and I'm getting very frustrated at myself. But yeah, the key now is to set my alarm. Good to know. But I experienced my first Thanksgiving at the weekend. I know Thanksgiving is today, but a teacher at Mario's school hosted Thanksgiving at her house last weekend, and I experienced my first Thanksgiving, and it's basically like Christmas. For those of you who aren't aware, there's a turkey, and there's a variety of food, and then I ate pumpkin pie, which is delicious. I had my first ever snickerdoodle, which is also delicious. And Mario and I made, well, I didn't make them, I just suggested them. Mario made mince pies, which are a British thing, and I love mince pies. It's something I really miss about living abroad, is just English food. Like, I know it's not the tastiest food in the world, but I miss really good curries, because in England we do curries really well. I miss mince pies and custard creams, which is a type of biscuit. But yeah. Thanksgiving was a lot of fun. They busted out the karaoke machine at the end, and I'd had quite a bit of apple vine, so went on the karaoke machine for a bit, which is always fun. I'm trying to think what else we've been up to. We went to see Finding Dory. We went to see Finding Dory, that's happened in the past fortnight. That was a lot of fun. And then we went to All You Can Eat Sushi directly afterwards, which, I mean, the sushi's incredible, but I felt a little bit guilty going to see Finding Dory and then eating fish, because Finding Dory is about a fish, for those who aren't aware. And we went to see it in English, obviously. Also, so we went to an early morning showing, because I mean, it's pretty late in the game now to go and see Finding Dory, so you go and see it when you can. And I hadn't had a drink all morning, so then I went and got a drink at this bottle, in fact. This is how tidy and clean I am. This bottle of water, so it's a 500 milliliter bottle of water, plus pfand at 25 cents. So in Germany, you pay for the bottle, and then you take the bottle back to a machine, and you get the money back on the bottle. So you pay 25 cents to have a bottle, and then you get the 25 cents back. Yeah? So this bottle of water, including pfand, at 25 cents, because it says it on the bottle, was €4.50. Extortionate. For water. Not impressed. Not impressed at all. But that serves me right for not having a drink before I went. But seriously, €4.50. Sorry, that just turned into a bit of a rant. But yeah, Finding Dory is a really cute film, and I really enjoy the Pixar short before it, which is called Piper, I believe. And it's about a little seagull, and it's so cute. It's so cute. It's ridiculously cute. I love it. I love it. But yes, I think that's pretty much everything I have to report. I think I'm going to go out and have a look around the Christmas market this afternoon before it gets too busy. Although I should go out and go in the morning, because it starts to get busy about now. And the bells are going to go soon, so I'm going to go now. I just want to say a huge thank you for the positive feedback that I got on my last podcast. Thank you to all of the shout outs that I've received through the week. That was amazing. Thank you. I woke up one morning and had 56 new Instagram followers because someone posted about me. So much appreciated. Super exciting. So thank you very much for that. I will be back with you in 2 weeks' time. So what will that be? The 8th of December, I think, because I've got a friend coming out on the 9th. I think it's the 8th. So that's exciting. I've got family coming out, not this weekend coming, but the next weekend. So that would, you know, dip into my knitting time a little bit, but that's okay. I'm excited to see my family. It's my mum's birthday this Saturday, so that's exciting. Sad I'm not going to be there, but that's okay. And yeah, I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button, which is under this video. It lets me know that you enjoy it. Feel free to let me know in the comment section below what you have been working on, any European based yarn, independent yarn dyers, would also be a great appreciation. I would also show great appreciation for that. Apparently I've been talking too much and not drinking enough tea because my voice is going and my brain has gone to mush. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, thumbs up. Don't forget to hit subscribe. I post a new craft tutorial every Sunday in the corner of craft, which is this channel here. And then every other Thursday you get a podcast like this one. And then in between you get other random videos. So I hope that you stick around for that kind of fun. But yeah, feel free to leave any yarn recommendations, pattern recommendations, anything at all. Let me know what you're working on. Feel free to join the Ravelry group. I will hopefully be having knit alongs, crochet alongs, that kind of thing in the future once we have grown a little bit, which is quite exciting. And yes, I'm gonna stop doing that with my needles because I'm getting on my own nerves. Links to my social media as well as other things that I think are relevant can be found in the description box of this video. And with all that being said, thank you very much once again for watching, and I shall see you very soon in Sunday's video. Bye. Welcome to the Craftea Chat Podcast. This is the first Craftea Chat Podcast. If you aren't new to my channel, as I'm sure many of you are not, you might be a little confused.